The president did lay out an aggressive environmental agenda, including creating new EPA regulations for cutting emissions at power plants, forcing the government to get 20% of its energy from renewable sources within the next 7 years, and ending support for companies building new coal plants overseas. Oscar-winning director James Cameron has been an outspoken environmental activist. He's made documentaries and even used his blockbuster movie Avatar to take on the issue of climate change. Cameron joins us now with reaction to the president's speech. James Cameron, thank you so much for joining us. Vice President Gore just called the speech the best speech on climate change by a U.S. president ever. But as you know, a lot of members of the public just don't find this issue all that compelling. Why should they?
No, they don't. First of all, thanks for having me on, Jake. Appreciate it. No, they don't. And, you know, look, it's tough economic times, and, you know, people want to pay the mortgage or the rent, you know, they want a job. And I used to be a blue-collar guy. I was a truck driver before I was a filmmaker, so I can relate to that. But I think people have to appreciate that you can't have a healthy economy, in an overheated world. The world that our kids are going to live in, you're going to have a very high food prices. You're going to have low crop yields because of higher temperatures and extreme weather, changing precipitation patterns. I mean, it's going to be very chaotic, and that's going to drop right to the bottom line of the economy, and it's going to drop right to the bottom line of national security. I mean, we're talking about a very, very, a huge test to the American people that's coming up as a result of climate change. I think the president's showing some pretty strong leadership here and taking on this problem, which is an unpopular problem amongst, obviously, the business interests in the country.
Did you think the speech went far enough, or for somebody like you who sees how difficult this is of an issue to move in the political sphere, is it just as far enough as you think he can get it?
I think it's a great opening salvo. I think it was comprehensive. I felt he defined the problem in clear language. He didn't waste time on what he called the debate with the Flat Earth Society, because, you know, as far as I'm concerned, the science is unequivocal. He got on with practical solutions, common sense solutions that are going to be beneficial economically and for jobs. I thought it was a very strong speech. I think it was as far as he can go at this stage. And obviously there's going to be a huge backlash from the right and from special interests. And it's going to be a battle just to accomplish what he's set forth. But it's a great opening round.
When you talk about special interests, one of those interests is coal. Mm-hmm. And there are a lot of people, blue-collar people, working people, who depend on coal. What's your message to them? President Obama seems to think that coal is a major problem. A lot of environmentalists do as well.
Yeah, well, coal is a pretty serious problem because it's our dirtiest source of power, and we're going to have to change. And, you know, there was nothing in his speech specifically about pricing carbon, but essentially you are pricing carbon if you're going to go after emissions from dirty coal plants. I think, you know, that we have to do what's in the common good, not just for the country, but for the world at large, and we've got to phase out coal. It's that simple. There's always going to be a temptation to use coal because it's the cheapest power out there. But look at China. We don't want to wind up like them with absolutely unbreathable air. I was in Beijing just recently, and it's literally unbreathable air, and a lot of it is particulate pollution from coal. So, you know, this is just something we have to face, and it's the nature of this country to have certain businesses that are supplanted by other businesses that are more in the common good and or more profitable. If coal wasn't profitable, nobody would mourn its demise. We only mourn its demise now because it's profitable, and so that we have to look clearly at that, and that's where I think the role of government should be in our lives.
All right, environmentalist and filmmaker James Cameron, thanks so much. We look forward to seeing you out in Los Angeles sometime soon.
I appreciate it, Jake. Thanks a lot.